start.
First motor, that DC motor. First one is the DC shunt motor. The parallel transformation of the two wire is connected across the common DC power supply. The resistance of the shunt field winding. Shunt field winding is always higher than the armature winding. This is the because of the number of last section is area of the wire used for the field winding is a small item. Start up the wire used for armature winding. This is the circuit diagram of DC shunt motor. The shunt field winding is your own. So the shunt parallel with the wire. This is the resistance shunt current. This is a load current. This is a supply voltage. This is the armature resistance. This is a
sigma.
Characteristics of DC shunt motor. The torque versus armature current. This is a torque. Armature is a torque. This is a shunt torque. Dotted lines. This straight line. This is the speed versus armature current. Armature current. This is this is the shunt current. Next one is the speed versus torque. This is armature torque. The characteristics of DC shunt motor is proportional to I into I. Is the torque, I the magnetic flux, I is the armature current, I is the constant here. So T is proportional to I. T is increases and armature current is also increases. N is proportional to V by pi. N is proportional to Vt minus Ia into Ra. This is armature. Speed is high. Voltage is also high. The second one is the DC shunt motor. This is the DC series motor. The field winding is connected in series with the armature. The current passing through the series winding same as the armature current. This is the armature current. The current is passing through. This is a load armature current entering to the armature. The current passing through series winding. This is a series winding same as the armature current. This is a field winding. Therefore, the series field winding has a turns of thick pair than the shunt field winding. Also, therefore, the field winding will possess a lower resistance than the armature winding. The characteristics of DC series motor. We know T is proportional to DC torque versus armature current. This is a armature torque shunt current. This is the dotted lines. T is proportional to IA. For DC series motor, IA equal to IF is equal to field current equal to current. So that E is proportional to I. Then we know EB is equal to M phi ZB by 16 Ohm. M is proportional to E by 5. So M is proportional to 1 by 5. M is proportional to 1 by IA. The equation of this is the back EMF equation. This is the back EMF equation. P is proportional to 5 into IA. P is proportional flux into armature current. N is proportional to 1 by IA. M increases, natural current is decreases. The third one is the DC compound motor. DC compound into divided into two parts. Long shunt compound motor, short shunt compound. Is to use cumulative compound motor, differential compound motor. The long shunt compound motor, the circuit diagram of long shunt connection in this series winding is connected in series with the armature winding. Series with the armature winding. Shunt winding is connected parallel with the armature connection. Parallel with the armature connection. This is the second one, the short shunt compound motor. This is circuit diagram of short shunt connection. In short shunt compound motor, the series winding is connected series to the parallel combination of the armature and the shunt winding. Then, let it start in the constant speed. Cumulative compound motors. With the two field winding, that is, engage such area that we have produced by one of the system. This is the cumulative compound motor. A field winding that is series shunt and engage such area that the flexes produced by one of the system. Thank you.